again. Push.
Okay, pull, gets this position. A lot of the time as well, you can hold this position just to keep his head in here. So what I'm doing is this. Okay. Just because I don't want to try and like, throw this in and go like one-handed too quickly. So a lot of the time I'll keep everything in there. So even though it's not like a full guillotine yet, it's difficult for him to come out of this. Okay, until eventually we get it through nice and deep and start attacking this. He gets his hands in there early. Okay, so this is kind of going onto his face a little bit. So maybe I realise that I'm not going to get the choke on this. So one or two things are going to happen, okay? Either I get the high elbow and he bails. Okay, so he just rolls. Okay, and that's how he escapes it. Okay. Or I just decide that this isn't working. Okay, so he's hand fighting. I just decide this isn't working, okay? So I keep the weight on this side, and because I've got this butterfly hook in, just lean back, take him over, and I can follow. Okay, if I end up in mat and I manage to get my high elbow over his shoulder again here, this is going to be pretty bad for the guy. Most of the time, he'll probably be able to shove that left shoulder and stop me getting it over. And maybe I have to let go, but it's not too bad for me. Okay, if we start in a butterfly position, I end up in mat. You know, it's not a bad return for my guillotine effort. So we'll get from here, push, move him, get this high. But he starts to defend. Scoot in close as well. So here. So you can throw and then come to mat, or you can follow with the hook. So here. Okay, keep my hook in this time. So look, I follow and stay attached. Okay, the other problem with this is he's probably going to grab my ankle with his legs. With the leg, that's it. This type of thing will happen. Okay? Which is, again, it's not the end of the world.
I could be here to release this. Okay? We'll try both of these ways of setting this up, okay? So you can either get to the guillotine, he defends and you sweep him yourself, or you can ask your partner to roll. Okay, so you start to get the guillotine high, he just flops to his side. Here. So you just follow him up. Okay, get on top, side control, mount, whatever. That makes sense, guys? So you're either forcing the sweep, or the sweep, the guillotine gets so tight that the guy just flops out of it, and you just follow him up. Yeah, so you should expect that to happen. So this is similar to, was it Diaz and McGregor, when Diaz went for the guillotine. McGregor tried to spin out of it and he ended up getting mounted, yeah, because Diaz followed him. Okay, let's try that, guys.